Marking 20 years of humans aboard the space station, getting out the vote from space, and preparations continue for NASA and SpaceX's next crew launch. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. November 2nd marked 20 years of humans continuously living and working aboard the International Space Station. As the only laboratory available for long-duration microgravity research, the space station has supported numerous discoveries, scientific publications, unique opportunities, and historic breakthroughs that help us explore farther into space and also benefit us here on Earth. Find out more at nasa.gov/station20. NASA's Kate Rubins became the latest U.S. astronaut to cast a ballot from space. NASA has used the Space Communications and Navigation Network to ensure Americans in space can vote securely since astronaut Dave Wolf became the first American to vote from space while on board the Mir space station in 1997. Preparations continue toward the launch of NASA's SpaceX Crew 1 mission to the International Space Station, currently targeted for November 14th at 7:49 p.m. Eastern Standard Time from our Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The mission will increase the size of the station's crew and also the productivity aboard the orbital outpost.
The amount of research that we can get done and the science that we can get done with just one or two more people is more than just one or two more people's worth of science. And so the ability for us to accomplish whatever needs to be accomplished goes way high with more people on the station.
Crew 1 is the first crew rotation mission to the space station of the SpaceX Crew Dragon spacecraft as part of the agency's commercial crew program. Our Lucy mission, which will be the first to visit the Trojan asteroids near Jupiter, was recently outfitted with its first scientific instrument. The Lucy long-range reconnaissance imager will provide highly detailed views of the surfaces of these never-before-seen bodies that scientists believe once were situated in the outer solar system. Lucy is targeted for launch in October 2021. Two of the advanced design propeller assemblies for NASA's first all-electric X-plane, the X-57 Maxwell, underwent wind tunnel testing recently at our Langley Research Center. X-57 will use the motors and propellers during takeoff, deactivate them during cruise mode to prevent additional drag, and then use them again to help the aircraft land. NASA's primary goal for X-57 is to share the electric propulsion design, lessons learned, and other data with regulators as new electric aircraft markets begin to emerge. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.